Hi, I am Mirza. I am presenting paper presentation. The title of the paper is Poe and Voxel CNN for Efficient 3D Deep Learning. 3D deep learning has used in a wide application like robots, AR, VR, and autonomous driving. This application requires low latency as it interacts to people with real time. The author discusses two methods with the limitation. These are voxel-based method and point-based method. Voxel-based method requires high resolution in order not to lose information. When resolution is low, multiple points are merged into the same voxel grid and the points are no longer distinguishable. From the figure, we can see the number of distinguishable points and memory consumption with different resolution. For example, on a single GPU with 12 GB RAM, the largest resolution is 64, which lead to 42% information loss. To keep 90% information, it needs the double of resolution to 128, consuming GPU memory of 82 GB. So GPU memory increases cubically with resolution. Point-based methods are memory efficient, but they lead to irregular memory access pattern and introduce dynamic kernel computation overhead. Neighboring points in the point-based representation are laid out contiguously in memory, so it requires explicit and expensive KNN computation. After KNN, it requires large amount of random memory access. For point-based method, we have to calculate the kernel of each neighbor. This will introduce additional matrix multiplication. From the figure, we find that irregular memory access and dynamic kernel computation for DGCNN is 55% and point CNN is 88%. Based on the analysis of the bottlenecks, the author introduced a hardware efficient primitive 3D deep learning. This is point voxel convolution, which combines the advantage of point-based method and voxel-based method. The point voxel convolution is shown in the figure. The upper portion is the voxel-based branch and lower portion is the point-based branch. The voxel-based branch consists of normalization, voxelization, feature aggregation, and devoxelization. First, voxelization is done, which transforms the point into low-resolution voxel heat. Then it aggregates the neighboring points by voxel-based convolution. Then devoxelation is done, which convert them back to points. Either voxelation or devoxelation requires one scan over all points, making the memory cost low. The point-based branch extracts the feature of each individual point by using MLP, which outputs distinct and discriminate feature of each point. Then feature fusion is done by aggregating both the individual branches. Point voxel convolution is more efficient than conventional point-based conventional because of better data locality and regularity. For voxelization and devoxelization, it requires order of n random memory access, where n is the number of points. But for point-based method, it requires at least order of kn random memory access, where k is the number of neighbors. Therefore, PVCNN is k times more efficient than point-based method. PVCNN does not require kn computation and dynamic kernel computation, which are expensive. As MLP is used, which is able to maintain the same number of points throughout the whole network, so high resolution is achieved. In this paper, the author experimented on multiple 3D tasks, including object part segmentation. Indoor segmentation and 3D object detection. For object part segmentation, they experiment on the large scale 3D dataset shape net parts. They build the PVCNN by replacing the MLP layer in pointnet with the PVConrail. It ensures that input data has the same size with 2048 points and base size of 8. For indoor sense segmentation, the author experimented on the large-scale indoor sense segmentation dataset S3DIS. For fair comparison, both data processing and evaluation protocol are same as PointCNN. They also extend PointCNN++ with PVCon to build PVCNN++. Finally, for 3D object detection, they experiment on the driving-oriented dataset KI-TTI. They evaluate all models for 20 times and generate the mean 3D average precision. They build a PVCNN based on a pointnet by replacing MLP layers with PVCon primitive. For object part segmentation, PVCNN outperforms all previous models. On average, PVCNN outperforms the point-based model with 5.5 times measured speedup and 3 times memory reduction, and outperforms the Voxel-based baseline with 59 times measured speedup and 11 times memory reduction. They also design the general version of PVCNN by reducing the number of channels to 25% and 50%. This also shows better performance. For indoor sense segmentation, on average, PVCNN and PVCNN++ outperform the point-based model with 8 times measured speedup and 3 times memory reduction. Outperforms the Voxel-based baseline with 14 times measured speedup and 10 times measured memory reduction. They also designed some compact models of PVCNN and PVCNN++ by reducing the number of channels, which show better performance. For 3D object detection, a PVCNN outperforms all classes with 1.8 times lower latency. It achieves 2.4 mean average precision improvement in the most challenging pedestrian class. A PVCNN outperforms a point plus plus in all categories with 1.8 times measured speedup and 1.4 times memory reduction. In PVCNN, memory increases sublinearly. By increasing the resolution from 16 to 32, the memory usage is increased from 1.55 GB to 1.59 GB. During deboxylation, the trilinear interpolation performs better than the nearest neighbor. The voxel branch captured large continuous part and the point branch captures isolated and discontinuous part. So the convolution operation extracts feature with continuity and locality. PVCNN increases the measured speedup and reduces the memory consumption, but the accuracy is not increases so high. This paper has focused on the detection of 3D object. It would be good to explore this proposed technique in other domains like searching 3D objects. In future research, can focus on the increase of performance in object detection using Voxel and PointSet abstraction layer. Thank you.